Hello, Ranos here, and welcome to an episode of Space Engineers. This episode we take a look at the tiered solar and wind turbines by Aimbot. It's a rather simple mod. It just adds a few new tiers of the solars and wind turbines. Obviously, it's the name of the mod. But didn't add any new models though. Or any new textures. Just use the vanilla stuff. So you can't really tell if something is a high tier or not. You just have to look at it with a welder or a grinder or something. And wait, why don't we go over and take a look at them? Right over here. So first person. You see? Three new tiers of solar panels, as well as wind turbines. And obviously, as you can tell, they can be recolored. There's also the solar panels for small ships. So, how much more powerful than vanilla are these? Well, the red one, which is tier 2, is 8 times more powerful than the vanilla version. The same goes for the wind and the small ship. Green one, which is tier 3, is 16 times more powerful than vanilla, while tier 4 is 32 times more powerful than vanilla. But here's also the thing, it costs just as well. The multiplying power they produce is equal to the amount of materials they need. So if you have 8 vanilla solar panels, you can compress them all down into one solar panel right here. Because it uses the exact same amount of resources. Which is, as you can see, 32 steel plates, 112 construction components, 96 girders, 256 computers, 256 solar cells, and 32 bulletproof glass. And since that was on 16, and this is 8, it just doubles, and then doubles again. So yeah, once you compress 8 solar panels onto this, and then you eventually make enough for a second one, you're going to compress both of those down into one of these. And then, start that whole process again. Like, you create a small area where you have 8 solar panels. Once you've got all 8 there, you compress them all down into one tier 2. And then say once you've built another 7 in that location, and you've got enough materials to build an 8th, you can compress all those down into another tier 2. Then again, you compress those 2 tier 2s down into a tier 3. And then you start the process all over again until you get 8 tier 4s. You can do that with these. Now, I don't have a vanilla versions of them both placed down because they seem to have vanished. As you can see, the tier, or the vanillas have disappeared for some reason. Although they got their own menu items here, the vanilla one has also been switched to these. Wait a minute, is this showing the frick? Why is it showing tier 4? Oh, so the vanillas are still here. I will be able to show you them compared to their vanilla counterparts. I just sworn that they weren't showing up. That's weird. Anyway, you see for vanilla, very cheap. Just 4 steel plates, 14 construction components, 12 girders, 4 computers, and 32 solar cells, as well as 4 bulletproof glass. So yeah, 8 of those becomes one of those. And then 2 of those becomes one of those, and 2 of those becomes one of those. And same with these ones. Where the vanilla version is 14 interior plates, 8 motors, 20 construction components, 24 girders, and 2 computers. This bugger is very expensive at 320 interior plates, 64 motors, 160 construction components, 192 girders, and 16 computers. And it gets even more expensive time goes on. Yeah, it's gonna cost you a lot. It's gonna be worth it. You're having so much power being produced from a smaller area. Now how about we check the power rating? And we can't look at what they're currently producing because, you know, they're not in the optimal position for that. But if you look at the max possible outputs, the vanilla is 160 kilowatts. We move to tier 2, and it's 1.28 megawatts. So that's 8 vanilla solar panels. And tier 3 is 2.56 megawatts. And tier 4 is 5.12 megawatts of power. So a single tier 4 solar panel could do pretty good for a base. You just gotta make sure you got your batteries in place. And now, the wind turbine. The vanilla's optimal output is 400 kilowatts, which means you do need a lot to power some bases. But with it 2, it's 3.2 megawatts. And then obviously that goes to 6.4 megawatts for tier 3 and 12.8 megawatts for tier 4. I'm not actually sure how many bases need this much power. Because in another world, where I was going to test the like NPC encounters, I actually created a base that has a bunch of vanilla wind turbines. Power a base. Anyway. I think like 5 or 6 of these tier 4s will be enough to power your entire base. But who knows, maybe your base might need more than that. But obviously a small base, say if you only had that little setup, without the pipes, like a little home, about a couple of vanillas will do you good. Are you going to place right? Right, as for the small ship, you got max possible output 40 kilowatts, that goes up to 320 kilowatts. Then 640 kilowatts, and finally 1.28 megawatts. That's very useful, especially if you have an electric powered land vehicle. So the max one, this one, will be able to give the ship quite a bit of boost in its power supply. So I have designed some electric powered land vehicles before. Like the primary power source came from a hydrogen engine. But they was able to be powered by its batteries, if need be, and had a solar panel on top to keep them charged. But obviously, it doesn't produce a lot, so the vanilla one doesn't. So if I had this on there instead, it would have been a lot better. That would have been equivalent to 32 of these. Did it weigh just as much? What's your weight? Around here somewhere. That's how much inventory space the components take up. Wow. 15,000 litres. It's going to take a while to build this. Do it all by hand. 16 tons. A freaking heavy solar panel. Oh. Yeah, they weigh just as much as, you gotta be careful about the weight when it comes to using these. It appears the tier 2 weighs just as much as 8 tier 1 vanillas. And that weighs 16 as much as, well, as much as 16 vanillas, and that weighs just as much as 32 vanilla. I guess, is the weight automatic? Yeah, I think the weight's automatic. That's interesting. Well, I guess you put this on a ship that can move around, you have to be careful about its weight. That's interesting. Really expecting that. Either way, if it's for a base, it's very useful. Especially with the wind turbines, because you can't put those on ships. They just don't work. The base will be pretty handy. Stick them out on a tower and it'll be pretty good. In fact, I will show you my own towers that I do with the wind turbines. Just need to find one of the locations. Here we go. Yeah, because this is a bloody hell. Yeah, this comes from the resource node mod, that one. And if you had this tiered, so a wind farm, you won't need 5 wind towers like I've got here. You can simply replace these with a tier 2. And it produces more than enough power for it. I'd be surprised how it needs. No, 5 is actually enough. You could replace all these with just a single tier 2, since a tier 2 produces as much power as 8 of these ones. Which is handy. So yeah, we have to reduce how many of these wind towers I've got. I won't do that though. Yeah, any good. Fly all the way back over there. And that's really all there is to this mod. Very useful, but compressing down all your wind and solar stuff so that they take up less space and produce just as much. Anyway, I am going to end this one here, and there will be a link in the description for this mod. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.